Hey guys, welcome to the channel and to this fifth episode of the Iskra build. So, I have basically completed the build. And there are a couple of small parts that I need to assemble. A couple of antennas, like this one, that is going on the spine of the dorsal of the fuselage, and a couple of small antennas on the underside as well. But apart from that, everything is in place, and we are ready to put some primer on this aircraft. So that's good. And I have, since the last update, I have attached the wings and the horizontal and vertical stabilizers. I have also attached the windscreen and dealt with some seams over here. I think I mentioned it in one of the earlier episodes that I had, or I was expecting some fit issues here, and yeah, I had some fit issues, but I think I have solved it, so I'm happy with that. And I have masked everything, and also I have fitted the gun barrel, the metal gun barrel, and also the pitot tubes on the wings here. And yeah, I think that leaves us with the next step, and that is to start to paint. I was following the suggestions by Crazy Chemist PL, a guy that I've been talking to a lot in the chat, and he suggested that I should glue the upper part of the wings first, and then deal with the low underside second. And I did exactly just that, and I think it worked really nice. I think I have the seams look quite nice. They almost look like panel lines. And the only gaps I had really was at the wing root here, at the rear end of the wing root, where I actually had to put some plastic card to fill the gaps, and after that I sanded and polished it, and I also rescribed the panel lines afterwards. And I'm very curious to see how that looks when I get some primer on that, if that is okay, or if I have to do some more work to finish that or to fix that. I think that the tail fin or the tail of the aircraft was something that I was a little bit worried about, but it wasn't that hard really. I simply sanded down the locating tab because I couldn't get the locating tab and the horizontal stabilizers to fit together. So I sanded down the locating tab, and then I glued the horizontal stabilizer in place, and after that I attached the tail fin. So yeah, that's that. And apart from that, I had to do a lot of filling and sanding on the upper part of the fuselage, the dorsal. And so I had to rescribe. Let's see if I can catch that on the camera. I had to rescribe a number of service panels that are on the top here. And rescribing, that is not my best my best thing to do. So, but I really tried to do my best here, and to try to be patient and not rush it, because one of the problems, or at least what my experience with the rescribing is, that once you start to get impatient and try to work fast, then there will be a problem. So it's best to have sort of plenty of time and be relaxed when you do that, because it's at least for me, it's a lot of pressure or mental strain to do rescribing. But I'm happy with the result. I think that I, of course, I could have done it better. There are a couple of mistakes here and there, but it's okay as it is. The reason why I'm a bit extra careful here is because, since I will paint this in a metal color, the Iskra isn't a bare metal aircraft, it's actually painted in a silver paint. So but that in this scale I need to use some kind of a metal lacquer paint, and so I have to be very careful with the surface and the finish if I want it to look reasonably good. So my plan is to prime this with UMP primer, and after that I will paint it with a lacquer based metallic color. I'm thinking of using this extreme metal polished aluminium from AK Interactive, and I will of course test it on a couple of plastic spoons first to see that it looks the way I want it. But I think that that is the next step here. I will also do some detail painting and finish all the small parts, like the undercarriage and stuff like that. And yeah, I think that basically that's it. So hopefully in the next episode I will have a painted aircraft to show you. Okay, so yeah, I think that's it. I cannot come up with anything more to say. So thank you for watching, and I see you in the next episode. Goodbye.